everyone, and welcome back to the Organized Notebook. In this video, we wanted to show you how to make a travel planner in Notion. And Notion is a great tool for creating travel planners because there are just so many functions and the databases are very useful for storing travel itineraries and travel destinations. So let's get started. First, start by going to an empty Notion page and let's title this travel planner. And let's go ahead and choose a cover photo. So press add cover, and we're going to change the cover photo here and go to unsplash. And let's choose something with flying birds. And we'll go with this picture. And you can reposition it. Save position. And let's go ahead and also add an icon. And for this, we can add something like a plane. And we'll choose the one that's departing. And now let's go ahead and go to the top right corner with the three dots and go ahead and do small text full width. And this is going to give you more space to work with in the travel planner. So now let's start planning this travel planner. And for this, we're going to do two databases. One database is going to be for your travel destinations, and another one is going to be for your travel itineraries. And eventually, we're going to link the two together. So let's first create a travel destination database by typing slash database. And we're going to go ahead and choose gallery view and add plus new database. And here we're going to call this destinations. And each of these cards are going to hold a city or location. And let's start filling these in. So let's click here. And let's say this one is Tokyo. And we don't need the created date, so we're going to delete this property. And we don't need tags, so we're also going to delete this property. And we're going to delete these two defaults that were entered here to begin with. And let's actually add a cover photo. So we're going to add cover, change cover, and we can go to unsplash and find a picture here. And let's choose a photo. And now we want to display the photo here. So for that, you have to go to the three dots here, and then we have to go to layout, and card preview should be page cover. And that's it. So let's actually delete these two. And we'll just work with this destination for now. So under the destinations, we're going to have a list of travel itineraries. So for that, we're going to make a table view database by typing slash database. And choose table view. And we're going to do plus new database. And let's title this travel itineraries. And now we're going to decide what properties we need in these travel itineraries. So each travel itinerary is going to hold your plan for the whole trip. So basically, this is just for each trip. So let's say that this is for a trip to Tokyo for 5 days. Day trip. And that means we need a property for date. So let's actually keep the tag so we can label the trip as a certain type. So maybe instead of tag, we'll actually call it type. Travel type. And we could categorize it such as solo or work. Friends, etc. So let's say that we're going on a 5-day trip with some friends, and we are going to add another one here, which is going to be the date. So you can add the start and end date here. And we can move this a bit closer so we can see it more clearly. And for now, that's about it, what we need. And later you might think of some things that you need to add more to this properties. But let's just put a date now. And you have to add end date toggle on and then put like this. And we have our first entry in here. And now let's actually open this up. So we want something to go in here such as packing lists or some kind of daily itinerary. So for that, we're going to actually change the database template by going to this arrow here and clicking plus new template. And we're going to call this itinerary entry. And we are going to start designing what's going to go inside here. So for this kind of itinerary, what we want would be some places to add, for example, your flight tickets or anything like that. So let's actually add first important documents. And we're going to change this into heading 3 and type slash divider underneath. And this is a trick we like to use for headings so it looks cleaner. And under there, we're going to add some embeds. So type slash, and then we're going to do embed. So you can basically embed whatever you want using this. So we're just going to duplicate this a couple times so you have some slots to put some important documents like hotel reservations and so on. So now after important documents, what we can add is some travel accommodation information. And here we can also put heading 3 and then slash divider. And here you could just add in list format, and you can click Command D just to duplicate this really fast. So in case you need to add accommodation information, you could put the address and links and things like that in this list. And then now let's add a packing list. So again, slash, and then you could choose heading 3 and you could start typing packing list. And we will type slash divider. And let's go ahead and add checkboxes. Then you want to do slash checkbox. And you can again do Command Control D to duplicate this many times for your packing list. And then finally, what we also need is a daily itinerary. So let's do slash heading 3 and daily itinerary and slash divider. And here what you can do is just do day 1 and Command Control D. And you could just copy this. So if you just highlight this like this, and then under here you just paste, then you can get another of these and you could just change the day, so on. So this is just a default template. So you could just put day 1 and day 2. And when you need, you can duplicate this more as you need. And finally, some other things that could be nice is to have a list of links just for reference, like if you have restaurants you want to go to and so on. So for that, let's do heading 3 again, slash heading. Click heading 3 and let's just say useful links. Useful links, and we're going to do slash divider. And here you can put slash web and you can do web bookmarks. And again, you can just do Command Control D, Command Control D, and you can get more web bookmarks. So this is the basics of your itinerary entry, and depending on how you want to use your travel planner, you may want to add more things to either the properties here or in the page itself. But we're just going to do something like this for now, and you just have to click back. So now if we click back to this Tokyo 5-day trip and you open it, you'll see that you can click this itinerary entry and it's going to load everything. So now you have this itinerary entry, and now what you can actually do is also go to this database template and set this as default. So whenever you create a new travel itinerary, it's just going to set it as a default. So let's just go ahead and put set as default. And let's actually delete the rows that we're not using. So for that, you can highlight it and then delete. So now we have one travel itinerary to Tokyo and we have one destination, which is Tokyo. So now let's examine inside here and how we can connect the two together. So for that, what we need to do first is to add another property here, which is a relation property. And we are going to click relation and we're going to connect it with destinations. And you have the choice to show on destinations, and we recommend doing this so you can keep track of everything. So let's just do add relation like this. And now we can put here Tokyo. So now it's linked. So if you go here, you'll see that it's linked to this travel itinerary, Tokyo 5-day trip. And what we like to do is now hide this by going to the 6 dots here and going to minimal for the show as part. So now it's hidden here and it looks way cleaner. So now let's think about what we want to put inside here. So we definitely want the itinerary to show up here. And if you like to plan ahead for your destinations, even if you have no plans to go there for fun, then we can put a section for travel research. So for these, let's now go again to the database template so that each time you make a new destination, it's gonna show the same thing. So we're gonna go to this arrow here and then click plus new template. And then here we're going to write destination entry. And on the top, let's start by adding a section where you can do some destination planning. So let's type slash heading, and then we're going to do heading 3. And here we're going to do destination research. And then slash divider. And under here, it's kind of free for you what you want to do. You could add bullet points of things you should be aware about, for example. And you can even add slash web bookmarks as well if you need. And you can duplicate these as needed. So this part could get quite long depending on how much research you want to do. So let's actually now add the linked view of the travel itinerary on top. So for that, we're going to do slash, and then you're going to type link. And then you'll see linked view of databases. So you're going to click that, and then you're going to choose what you want to link it to. And this is going to be the travel itinerary. So if we click that, then you're going to see everything in travel itineraries. And what we want to do is make sure to filter it by the destination entry so that it matches here. And for that, we're going to click filter and we're going to filter by destinations and we're going to do it by destination entry and save for everyone. And now what we need to do is hide this column because it's going to be very obvious which destination we're referring to. So we're going to go to the 3 dots here and we're going to not show that property by clicking here. And we're also going to go ahead and hide this database title so that it looks cleaner. And for that, we go to layout and then we're going to toggle off show database title. So now we have a pretty clean layout here of our destination entry and we're going to click back. So now if we go back to Tokyo and we can click on destination entry inside Tokyo. And you'll see that the Tokyo 5-day trip shows up here like this correctly with destination research under it. And now what we can also do, just like the travel itineraries, is to put it as a default template so that whenever you add a new destination, it's going to be set as default. So we're going to click here for all views and destinations. And now we can go ahead and hide the database titles just so that it looks cleaner. So if we go to the 3 dots here, we can access layout and we're going to toggle off show database title and we're going to do the same in travel itinerary. So click the 3 dots, we're going to go to layout, toggle off show database title, and that's basically it. So you can add more destinations here by clicking plus new, and you can add more travel itineraries by clicking plus new. And obviously there's a lot you can do with this travel planner if you want to add widgets for the weather at your destination and so on. So that's the basics of creating a travel planner with Notion. And if you'd like more advanced features, we also have some travel planners and travel journals over on our store, and we'll leave the links for that in the description below. If you want the completed version of this template, we'll also leave a link to that in the description. And if you have any questions, comments, or anything that was confusing about this tutorial, let us know, and we hope to see you in the next one.